Andrew Thom found his calling the day his second son was born.
Our second son was a NICU baby.
Sadly, his son passed away at 8 months old. Thom and his wife had more children, but he never forgot the nurses who cared for his baby.
You know, I think that's the path I want to take.
Now a nurse working at Novant Health's Presbyterian Intensive Care Unit, helping other families the way the nurses helped his.
Just going every day and knowing that you're the only one there that's there for him.
Especially now that Thom finds himself in the midst of a pandemic he says no one prepared for.
Our whole world got flipped upside down.
Thom says he'd trained for a sprint, wound up running a marathon. At home, he couldn't love on his children the way he wanted.
They always come in and give me a big hug. Well, now it became a high foot until I've decontaminated.
At work, he was seeing and hearing about too many goodbyes.
They tried to stave off the ventilator as long as they could, and that patient chose to use that last phone call to say goodbye to their loved ones. And you'll never get used to that, you know, especially seeing the cases in the ICU, knowing that they might be right. They might not come off that ventilator. That's a tough thing to swallow.
As COVID-19 cases are spiking again, hospital staff are stretched thin. Thom has this to say to people who say it's all just a hoax.
I honestly wish we could get more cameras in to see people paralyzed, intubated, chest tubes, dialysis, all these measures that it takes to keep them alive. And yeah, that's a very small percentage of the positive COVID cases, but they are out there.
And as so many people are preparing to give thanks this week, Thom would just be thankful if he doesn't have to see you in his ICU.
People are going to do what they want to do. So I just hope they do it responsibly.